Hey, everyone. Please take your seats if you haven't already got one. Otherwise, just my job is just to bring everything to order and to welcome you here. Seems like we just did this a few weeks ago, and I kind of like the trend, don't you? Don't make me bring this out again. You might remember last year I had this guy. Most of you were here last year, I think, as well. So I'm here to introduce Kathy Savitt, the incredible president of Boom Supersonic. But before that, we might have a groundbreaking going on here today. Unfortunately, the rain yesterday and earlier in the week is going to prevent us from being able to be on the site for that groundbreaking. But I want all of you, after we're done, to step out that door, and literally the site is right there, and I'm looking at it from here. Step out that door, there's two flagpoles over there. Those flagpoles frame where the site is. You can actually walk across the road if you want to. If you do so, look to the left and look to the right before you cross. It is a one-way road, but we have some people get confused from time to time, so be safe. But when you walk over there, if you head down to where the American flagpole is, and you look across, you can see the cars on Interstate 73 off in the distance. The Boom site is immediately this side of 73. This morning, I walked out there because I wanted to make sure that I was giving you all the proper directions as I'm talking to you. And by the way, who was here last year? Put your hand up if you were here. It's a good part of this crowd. It's a little bit warmer this year, right? Last year was the first time in my life I ever did a speech with gloves on. Go back and look at the video. But when I walked out there this morning, just to case this, and getting a look at where the site was, it occurred to me that sidewalk over there, it is the scene of probably 50 phone calls between Ann Bilecki from Boom and myself, back during the days of us trying to convince this company that this was the obvious site for Overture to be built. And it just occurred to me standing out there that the fact that we're here to celebrate this all today is so unbelievably cool to me and to all of us, I think. So Kathy, I'd like to point out also that our teams working together as always, and in the interest of providing a proper groundbreaking, even though we can't be out there at the site, have had the very clever idea of bringing the site to us. So here it is right in front. And if you were all with that, join me in welcoming President Kathy Savitt of Boom Supersonic.
Well, thanks, Kevin. It is great to be back at PTI and Triad, and soon home of Boom Supersonic's first super factory for Overture. Today, we're going to celebrate our groundbreaking and kickoff for the super factory, which we believe is a really important milestone towards making the world dramatically more accessible via sustainable supersonic air travel. It's my honor to give a special welcome and heartfelt thank you to North Carolina's Governor Roy Cooper, Chief Deputy Secretary of Commerce Jordan Witcher, North Carolina Senate Leader Phil Berger, all of whom we can look forward to hearing from in just a few minutes. You have to suffer through me a little bit. But before we get going, I also want to recognize and thank the many important elected officials locally who are here with us today, whose leadership and vision were instrumental to our decision to locate the super factory in the Piedmont Triad. Please stand when I read your names so I can make sure we can all thank you. North Carolina Secretary of Transportation, Eric Boyette, Representative Ashton Clements, Mayor Nancy Vaughn of Greensboro, Mayor Jay Wagner of High Point, Mayor Alan Joins of Winston-Salem, Skip Alston, Chair of the Guilford County Board of Commissioners, and David Plyler, Chair of the Forsyth County Board of Commissioners. Well, just over 1 year ago today, it was literally January 26, 2022, our team and I came here a day with a bit worse weather conditions than we have this afternoon. Wow, and I wore no coat. To announce Boom's decision and selection of the great state of North Carolina and specifically the Piedmont Triad as our site for our first super factory. Boom made that decision based on a number of compelling factors, and those include the area's large workforce of skilled, experienced people, access to some of the world's best universities, colleges, and technical schools, home to several top-tier aviation and aerospace suppliers, and of course, PTI's proximity to the Atlantic Ocean as we look forward to testing Overture over the water for flights. And of course, North Carolina's shared vision of building a facility and a campus that will add value and tangible benefits for this entire community and the state for decades to come. Additionally, we were deeply and continue to be deeply impressed by North Carolina's growth in the aerospace manufacturing sector. In fact, it's 3 times faster than the U.S. national average, and new home to more than 200 aerospace suppliers and hundreds more aerospace companies and hundreds more in the supply chain. And unsurprisingly, North Carolina was recently recognized by CNBC as the top state for business in 2022. So on the end, yay. I feel very proud, and I've kind of only lived here for a year. I do know that I speak for everyone at Boom Supersonic when I say that we could not be more proud and excited for our future here. Over the past 12 months, both Boom and this region have had significant growth and made real progress. So I wanted to just quickly touch on a few highlights. In July of last year, we went to the Farnborough Air Show in England, and we introduced the final production design of our Overture airliner. You're gonna get to see a copy of that, or one of those, in a little bit, as well as announced 3 tier 1 suppliers, Collins Aerospace, Eaton, and Safran Landing Systems. Also at Farnborough, we announced our defense partnership with Northrop Grumman for Overture's defense and government market opportunities. With Northrop, we're developing a special mission variant of Overture to support both the U.S. government and her allies. This is a partnership that will significantly expand Overture's market, which means more business for the superfactory and this region. A month later, on August 16th, we were super proud to announce our largest order to date with American Airlines, 20 Overtures and an option for an additional 40. The American Airlines agreement brought our order book to 130 aircraft, which also includes previous orders and pre-orders from United Airlines, and pre-orders from Japan Airlines. And just last month, we were here inside, we got smart the second time around, on December 13th, and we announced Symphony, our sustainable and cost-efficient engine for Overture, along with 3 of our foundational industry-leading suppliers, Florida Turbine Technologies for the design, GE Additive for the important additive manufacturing processes, and Standard Aero for maintenance. Symphony, as we said last month, it is a Boom-led collaboration with our world-class partners, and we believe will deliver a supersonic engine that is ultimately far more efficient and economical for our customers, and that means ultimately for Overture's future passengers. Throughout the year, we also made substantive progress and announcements about this Overture superfactory, even though we had yet to move any dirt. This past fall, on September 12th, we announced our selection of BE&K Building Group with their deep experience in aerospace and aviation, along with their partner BRPH to design and build our beautiful, soon-to-be-built building. We're grateful for their partnership, and we'd ask all who are here from both firms to raise their hands to the audience so we can recognize you. Later, we announced our partnership with the Air Company. Now, the Air Company, if you don't know, is a leader in carbon-negative products, and we've agreed to buy up to 5 million gallons per year of their air-made sustainable aviation fuel, which will actually power Overture's test flights right here at the Superfactory. This represents another important step towards Boom's commitment for a net zero carbon footprint in 2025. Before the end of September, we also announced our first tooling and automation partner for Superfactory, AIT, Advanced Integration Technology. Now, this partnership is going to help us ensure the on-time production launch of Overture, very important, by providing us tools that are necessary for the fuselage and the wing assembly, as well as wing to fuselage joining. So now let's take a closer look at the Overture Superfactory's 62-acre site that, when finished, will house Boom Overture's final assembly line, test facility, and ultimately the first customer delivery center on the planet. Starting now through mid-24, we're going to be building the Superfactory, and with our partners BENK and BRPH. I'm coming back here in 2 months. I want to see sticks in the ground. I just want that on the record right now. And immediately upon completion, we're going to take occupancy and begin work with AIT to fully outfit the Superfactory with tooling and equipment. From there, we start our employee training, and all of this will keep us on track for the start of Overture production in 2024, assembly in 2025, and first rollout in 2026. Looking across the full Overture schedule, we remain on track and hopeful for our type certification in 2029, which will pave the way for Overture to carry her very first passengers. At the Overture Superfactory, all three of our critical design principles will be standard operating procedure from day one: speed, safety, and sustainability. Since I think we all understand the speed part, I'll touch briefly on safety and sustainability. At Boom, safety is deeply embedded into our DNA and across our country, across our company. And the Superfactory will operate with the most stringent of safety standards, including a robust safety management system, which we'll put in place before we even begin production on Overture. Moving to sustainability, last year at this very sort of announcement, we pledged that the Overture Superfactory will be LEED certified, ensuring that our manufacturing practices are sustainable. We project that the Superfactory will be at least 22% more energy efficient than similar buildings of its ilk, and we'll accomplish that through high-efficiency air conditioning, LED lighting, and improved insulation. As all of these efforts ramp, so will our local hiring. One of the reasons I spoke about at the beginning, and we've spoken about extensively over the past year, has been the Triads and North Carolina's incredible talent pool, both professional and academic. We remain fully on track to employ more than 1,750 people here by 2030, which will grow to more than 2,400 by 2032. Specifically, we're going to be looking for manufacturing engineers and technicians, mechanical and industrial engineers, operations, facilities management, and supporting administrative roles. All high-paying, great jobs right here in the region. We're also deeply committed to helping develop the next generation of aerospace talent. Our North Carolina internship program will formally kick off later this year. We need an office for them to be in, so our first class of interns will start in the summer of 2024. And as a reminder, those are geared for students who attend university, community college, and or technical schools in North Carolina. We plan to create more than 200 of these opportunities through 2032, and we're already working and enjoyed the partnerships with a bunch of these colleges and organizations in the area to understand how to best engage and serve their students. Today, we're pleased to have leaders from North Carolina A&T State University, the University of North Carolina Greensboro, Guilford Technical Community College, Greensboro College, and Elon University. Please raise your hands so we can thank you for being here. According to North Carolina's Labor and Economic Analysis Division, the Overture Superfactory is on track to add an estimated $32.3 billion to the state's economy over the next 20 years. There's a lot of history to be made here together, and we are incredibly proud to build it with you. And now it's my great pleasure to welcome North Carolina's Governor, Roy Cooper, to the stage.
This is, and I remember exactly 1 year ago today, we were out there, and it was very cold, but we were warned by what we were doing, this fantastic announcement for this company that's coming right here in the Triad in North Carolina. You know, right before I was governor, I talked to a lot of people here in the Triad, and there was positive momentum here, but a lot of frustration. We had the mega site that we couldn't fill and we were working hard. I kept saying, guys, the Triad is going to take off. Listen to me, it's going to take off. Sure enough, you've done it. All of us together have done it. And it is amazing to see what is happening right now with economic development here in the Triad. And I think the key to that success has been clean energy and aeronautics. When you look at clean energy in North Carolina, we are becoming the place that people are looking to for clean energy companies. And just look at Toyota EV batteries right here in the Triad. With VinFast building electric vehicles, we finally got that auto manufacturer that we've been looking for in North Carolina for decades, and it's gonna build EVs right here on the front of the wave. We've got Forza X1 that's gonna come and build electric recreational boats right here in North Carolina. And of course, this great Boom Supersonic, committed to getting to carbon zero, getting people where they need to go faster. And you know, when you think about the aeronautics side of things, already the Triad have a good base for that. But we're seeing significant growth in the area, and when you look at what just happened with Pratt & Whitney just down the road, significantly going to grow the workforce ecosystem for aeronautics here in North Carolina. So because of what will happen here on the ground here, Boom Supersonic will create speedy flights to get people connected with the world, making sure that we do it at record speed and that we are expanding our international economics, our culture, and our travel. And when you think about that, it is truly exciting. A lot has happened in that 365 days since we announced Boom Supersonic was coming. And it's amazing that we're here ready to break ground. And you mentioned your Symphony engines, and just know we're open to being ready to make them for you here, right here in North Carolina as well. She's already heard that from us. But we are ready to break ground now and to take flight. And when I think about the families that will benefit for these higher paying jobs that are coming here, and when I think about the spinoff benefits that are gonna help small businesses here in the Triad, and when I think of the impact that the building of these planes is gonna have on the world, I get truly excited. And so I wanna thank everyone for the work that you've done. Kathy, we look forward to continuing to work with you and Blake
and your team. We know that this is a partnership. We appreciate deeply the General Assembly. Senator Berger here is with me today. There are a lot of other members here, in addition to Representative Clemens. I see Senator Michael Garrett, Senator Brad Robinson, Senator David Craven, Senator Amy Gailey. There, I'm going to leave it to you to recognize the other legislators because I see some other faces. But I want to thank the bipartisan work that has occurred on economic development in the General Assembly. You guys have provided the resources. You have trusted us to go out and to make the right kind of deals for our state, to turn down the bad ones, to find the good ones, to help recruit the very best businesses. And we appreciate that. When you think about what this is going to do with over $32 billion in economic impact to this state over the next 20 years, that is extraordinary. And we appreciate that partnership. We also appreciate all of the work here in the Triad. You guys work together from your cities, your counties, your community colleges, your universities, your economic development groups, all working in coordination with the state to make this happen. I talked to a lot of CEOs. They deeply appreciate that because they know we speak with one voice and we work together. And we've got our transportation team here, Secretary Boyette and Chair Mike Fox of the Board of Transportation. We are ready to go from day one. And I want to thank our team from my administration. Our Secretary of Commerce, Michelle Sanders, could not be here with us today, but she has spent a significant amount of time on this effort, and it sends her regards today. We have Jordan Witcher, who is the Chief Deputy Secretary of Commerce, who's going to say a word or two to you in a minute. We have Lee Lilly, who's the head of our Pandemic Recovery and Economic Development Area, and Chris Chung, our Economic Development Partnership of North Carolina, which works hand-in-hand with the Commerce Department, is absolutely critical. So I want to thank all of them for the good work on this. We still have a lot to do. As Kathy says, we need to get this construction started and get it going and make sure that this happens at the end of the day. But I believe it will because I believe in North Carolina. And so now I'm going to introduce to you the Chief Deputy of our Department of Commerce, who's worked so hard on this, Jordan Witcher. Jordan?
Thank you so much, Governor, and good afternoon, everyone. I want to bring greetings on behalf of my boss, the Secretary of Commerce, Michelle Baker Sanders. As the Governor said, Secretary Sanders and everyone in our department was proud to be a partner in this project, and I really want to congratulate Kathy and Boom on reaching this milestone in their journey at PTI today as a company and as a new manufacturer in North Carolina. You know, exciting economic development opportunities like this one depend on a lot of factors. But one factor that's at the top of the list every time these CEOs come to North Carolina is, does the community that we're talking to have the workforce to be successful? Can we find the people that we need to continue to build our brand and our airplanes in this case, and our effective education and skills training systems in place? And we think about that a lot at the Department of Commerce, and we spend a lot of time working on enhancing North Carolina's ability to do just that. We know in today's business world that skilled, well-trained, reliable workforce is a huge competitive advantage, and it's a huge competitive advantage that we have in North Carolina and in the Piedmont Triad area. Successful workforce development programs bring together tons of people and organizations that are pulling together and working toward a common goal. Universities and community colleges and businesses and the many local and regional partners that we have form the backbone of North Carolina's workforce system, which is known here as the NC Works system. All of these groups bring something unique to the system and to the table to make sure that we continue that pipeline. So I'd like to thank all of the workforce system partners that are here today to help create the environment to bring them to North Carolina. Our workforce in North Carolina has been one of our biggest strengths, And Kathy and the team at Boom has told us that they chose Greensboro and PTI for this super factory because of the large and growing aerospace talent pool. And the high quality schools that Kathy mentioned, both here in the Triad and across the state. Boom is, was mentioned as already working with Guilford Technical Community Colleges and other local schools to explore customized training opportunities that will support the company's future hiring, starting with internships in 2024. And beyond Guilford Tech, Boom has already started building relationships with schools across the state to include North Carolina A&T, Forsyth Tech, NC State, and others. And we know that there's going to be a lot coming down the line in terms of additional apprenticeship and internship and on-the-job training opportunities. You know, we rolled out last year North Carolina's strategic plan for economic development. We called it the First in Talent Plan. And the entire plan is underlined about our continuing to build and support the skilled workforce that we need in North Carolina. Governor Cooper believes, and we believe, that every person in our state should have every opportunity to land a good job and keep a good job that will keep them in North Carolina. And that means incredible access to education and specialized training and a system that goes from cradle to career to help lift up North Carolina's workforce. So I appreciate Governor Cooper's leadership, mad at everyone here today, for his vision and for leading us all towards a better, more diverse, more inclusive future for North Carolina. In today's business world, we know that North Carolina has to be first in talent, just like we were first in flight. So again, on behalf of the Department of Commerce, thank you very much. And now it's my honor to introduce the President Pro Tem of the North Carolina Senate, Senator Burke.
Thank you, Jordan. Governor, you sort of put me on the spot because I only saw the four senators, so there's more than the four here. Senator Garrett, Senator Robinson, Senator Craven, and Senator Gailey. If there are other, and Representative Clemens, if there are other members of the General Assembly here, please stand up.
I'll leave myself.
I have stood in front of crowds before and missed several people, so I don't want to do that because, you know, we talk a lot about who's contributed, who's done something. But ultimately, the work of the General Assembly in creating the kind of environment that North Carolina has that's conducive to growth and development, conducive to our strong university system, conducive to our great community college system. The people of North Carolina send those folks to the General Assembly to do the kind of work that results in things like this. So this is a great day. And Kathy, I told you that the folks in the Triad were really excited about Boom. And I think you can tell that from the crowd that that is here today. One of the challenges of speaking after a lot of other folks have spoken is everything's pretty much been said. It's just that not everybody has said it. So I would like to recognize a couple people. I think I see Henry Isaacson over here. Henry, if you're here, I remember. I remember the day that you and Kevin and several others came to my office in Eden and talked about what could happen here at this airport if we did certain things. And it's that kind of foresight, that kind of thought process that results in these kinds of results. So Kathy and Boom, we're so happy to have you here in the Triad. We know you're going to be successful. The state of North Carolina, now sometimes when people say this, you run the other way, but the government's here to help. And we'll do what we can as far as your state government to help you be successful. I want to thank everybody for being here. Governor, thank you for being here. Again, congratulations to both.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Paul Menger, and I have the honor and privilege to be the current chair of the Piedmont Triad Airport Authority. And on behalf of our board of directors, both current and past, as mentioned, the past is very important because they've laid an important groundwork to let us do the work we're able to do today. So on behalf of our board and prior boards, and all of the employees of our aerospace campus, we really, again, thank and welcome Boom to the Triad. We also thank everyone who has helped lead to the great things we have today, and it's a long list has been made, but I'm going to repeat some of it because I think it bears worth repeating. Governor Cooper, we appreciate your administration helping with this. We appreciate the work done in the House of Representatives, and unfortunately the Speaker couldn't be with us, but we appreciate his leadership. And Senator Pro Tem Berger, we greatly appreciate all that the Senate has done and the whole North Carolina legislature to lead us to where we are today. We also appreciate all of our municipal officials and the many others who have worked to get us here today. 1 year after the announcement, the grading is complete, the plans are approved, and earlier this week our board approved, and I had the privilege of signing the lease for the Boom Superfactory facility. This extraordinary superfactory is being built on the grounds and on the groundwork that was laid many years ago. The visionaries who saw a future for the Triad in the aerospace sector and had the courage to make it happen. We thank them and we thank everybody for being here with us today. Boom's vision is not only to build a superfactory, but a supersonic airplane, but also one that has sustainability with an innovative supply chain, all of which makes for many opportunities here in the Triad. This includes building new, promising technology, creating high-paying, high-technology jobs here in the Triad. Boom will be joining our other aerospace partners, including Honda, HACO, FedEx, Textron, and many others in employing over 8,000 people on our airport campus. I believe this is a region and regional cooperation, Mr. Fox, that has led to being able to attract and provide the facilities necessary for Boom to be successful. This region stands ready to benefit enormously, but also stands ready to assist in every way possible. Kathy, Blake couldn't be with us today. On behalf of our 8,000 aerospace employees and leaders here on this campus, I want to congratulate you and thank you and let you know we are all here to work with you and support you in your mission.
Okay, thank you to all of our speakers, to the governor, to Chief Deputy Secretary Richard, to Senate Leader Phil Berger, and thank you again for your kind comments. Now, as you can tell, we are passionate about realizing our ambitious yet audacious mission. And we know that to succeed, we do need the leadership and partnership of people, companies, and communities that share our drive and commitment to innovation. So throughout the year ahead, I can promise you that we're going to continue to update you as well as engage and be part of our local communities here in the Piedmont Triad as we move every day a step closer to the first overture aircraft rolling off that assembly line right here at PTI. So before we grab our shovels and celebrate this milestone, I want everyone to know that we need a couple, it's gonna be maybe 10, 20 seconds so we can set this up. But we are now going to do our ceremonial groundbreaking, not in the cold. Thank you again. Thanks again for coming.
Sit on the front row. You want me to splash it over?